A lot of people have asked me why I run a reverse tee or reverse blind. What's it good for? I'll tell you exactly. This situation right here is exactly what it's good for. Sit. I've got a huge pond that you can see. That's flooded timber all back in there. There's no way that I can get in there without putting a boat in and all that kind of mess to plant my blinds. Well, this is the situation where this reverse comes in extremely handy. I can put a dog in a good timber situation. It's a 75, 80 yard swim across this open water. Then there's, oh, a good 100 yards of flooded timber back in there. So I can run 200, 225, maybe even 30 yard blinds in this one area with Kizzy. And over here, it's even more timber. But right now what I want to do, there's a couple old trees out there that's about at 120, 125 yards, just inside the timber, a good 35, 40 yards. And I'm starting to push her through big open water into some of that timber. I hunt a lot of timber, so I don't want my dogs used to going into it. Fetch. Good girl. Here. Heel. Here. Sit. Here. Good. Good part. No. But. She's getting her lines real good. I've not run her to that, and she's actually holding a real good line. As you can tell, I've really been working Kizzy on those pattern blinds. You saw where I started them with this reverse, and that's a perfect line. She is going as straight as you can ask. Now she's hooking a little bit to the right, but I want to make sure she goes to the left. Back. Perfect. That's where pattern blinds really pay off on you. Getting some real good straight lines. I've done them all on land. I've instituted some here on this pond on the other side. I've not run this actual blind with it. So this is a cold blind. This is a cold blind with a bumper in her mouth running it as a reverse. I just love this drill. She's about to make it to those trees over there, and you can't ask for any better than that. That spot right there is exactly where I wanted her to go. It took me about, two or three whistles once she got past that initial spot over there, got back in the timber. So that's just where, you know, this next time that I run her, she ought to run right to those two trees, no problems whatsoever. Back! No! Here. Now, that's what dog training is right there. We're going to step up here, sit, dead bird, back. No, no. Here. We're going to step up again. Hold, dead bird. Here. Come on. Sit. Here. Heel. Here. All I did was step up closer, cast her. Now this time she ought to go to those two trees pretty much in a straight line. She thought we was going to do a little something different, but I didn't ever call her correct. All I did was simplify, step up, make her choices easier, easier, easier till we got it right. I guess if she kept getting offline, I would have ended up in the water. Now you can't ask for any better than that. Those two dead trees out there is what I'm shooting for, and she's going right to them. Good girl, come on. And that's right there is just about as good as you can ask for. The reverse tee, reverse blind, whatever you want to call it, I swear is one of the best tools for teaching your dog a whole lot of things. You can work with cheating bank scenarios, you can establish blinds, you can run your dog literally all over the place on the field, and it just tells them to turn it off. When you say dead bird back, to turn off all their inclination to go out there and find something, you are the driver. You know, I'm the driver now. When I say dead bird back, and that's what you got to get over to your pooch when you say dead bird. He needs to turn off anything for him looking for a bird until he gets way out there at least. Come on, girl. Good girl. Dead bird. Back! She's a little left on my line. But I think she's remembered. What we're doing here is we're trying to establish really, really good straight lines. And you can't really ask for any better than that. I mean, for what I'm doing, this right here is exactly what I'm asking for. And there you have it. She's ran this blind 3 times. She's got a real good straight line. And I won't run this again. I won't run this today. I won't run it tomorrow. I may run it here in another week. But I'll pick another spot and do the same thing. Get a good straight line. And I'm teaching a dog line, a drive to go straight. A lot of different concepts right here. And I think this reverse T really, really helps them concentrate on where they're going and slow down that thought process. But if your dog lacks a little bit of drive, you can still do this drill, but you need to all the time, it's got to be good things. And what a lot of times as I'm working a field, I will walk with the slower dog, you know, casting them. And as they're running, you know, lollygagging, I will walk behind them and stay within a good handling distance. Good girl. Here, sit. Good girl. All right. Let's have some fun. Up. Get that bird.